Let's look at question 11 since it looks a little backwards. It's not in descending order, but the strategy we're using will work if the question is written this way as well. Factors of 4, again, 1 and 4 or 2 and 2. I'm going to try 2 and 2 first. If I can choose the same numbers, then it ends up, so if you have a perfect square, a little bit less guessing in your first try. Factors of 25, okay, are, again, 1 and 25 or 5 and 5. I'm going to try 5 and x and 5x. I know the signs have to be both negative because two numbers that multiply to positive 25 and add to negative would have to be both negative. So let's check my insides and my outside, and I've already got my answer of negative 20x. Let's try 12 since it's also the same kind of question. Factors of 16. Again, if I have a perfect square, I usually try that first. I know the signs have to be both negative because two negative numbers multiply make a positive, and if you add them, you're going to get a negative. Let's try 7x. I doubt it's 1 and 49. Check the middle terms. Check the outside terms multiplied together. When you add those, you get negative 56, which is our middle term.